Don't know if you can see them, but there's the chatterboxes, the Pasadena parrots. Oh God. Right behind me too, where are you? He's looking down at me like, what the heck do you think you're doing? He's like, what the? Who's this fool? Oh no, he's got a video cam. Love parrots. I kind of find them to be the court jesters. The winged court jesters. The clowns. The winged clowns. There, let's see. Oh. There you are. There you are. No photographs, please. So here's where we are now. Now that the fairs have resumed as of yesterday. After 2 years, it's kind of a shock, you know. I mean, we all locally here got used to having free rides everywhere. Subway, upper trains, buses, and only for the metro so far. Or I mean, the other transportation companies and stuff throughout the cities, they each had their own times to resume. But for right now, and this is only until July 20th, these fares. But you have to apply also for a senior or a discounted low income application to get a card, which is what I had already done. But still, that's a lot of money. I mean, it's $100 a month normally, see? I think I can remember as early as the RTD, before we had the Metro. RTD was a rapid transit district here in Pasadena, or I mean in Los Angeles, Southern California. And that was, I think 25 cents is the earliest that I remember. Yeah. $1.75. Folks, how you doing? Welcome back. It's Charlie. It is Tuesday morning, December 11th, or December, January. Please, let's not go backwards now. January 11th, 2022. It's about 10:20 in the morning, and I am just now leaving the beautiful Methodist Church. I will have to do a video here of this beautiful, beautiful, outdoor beautiful, and even more so beautiful inside church. There's so many churches here in Pasadena. I had long planned on doing a video, or at least a series, of all the churches and temples and places of worship here in Pasadena. But It's quite a bit of work. I'd have to really download a huge list, because you wouldn't think that we would have so many places of worship here, both large and small, temples, synagogues, churches, and this place in particular. One of my friends, one of my advocates, she goes, this is her church, and it just inside is just spectacular. One of the other ones, just down over here on the street, where am I pointing? Down over here, block to the left, the Presbyterian Church, that one's just as beautiful too. So hopefully we'll see. Tired. I have been up since about 3:40, 3:42 this morning. Oh man. Tough love, really? Must be related to Carla. I think you're related to Carla. You must be. That woman loves to emasculate men. She just loves tearing down and stuff like that, but ugh. So I got up early this morning and had to upload that video. Life is such a chore now. It is just definitely more than it ever was before. I can honestly say that if she never entered the picture, life would have been a lot more easier. If another tenant had moved in, even the other lady that used to live there, the other two ladies, Janelle, she was really sweet. She was overly considerate because she used to occupy the room where Carla does, and we introduced each other, and she likes to, and she was very always apologetic. She's always such a sweet, always apologetic, and she tell me she liked to listen to music. I'm like, yeah, sure, no, whatever, and if she played her music and I had to go into the kitchen or use the bathroom or whatever, back when I was still using and taking a shower in that house. You know, by the way, I have not had a shower in that house since April of 2020. I've only had two full showers, and that's the two times that I was hospitalized at Huntington. This whole time's just, I've been maintaining. Just like I've been maintaining, being homeless, baby wipes and taking bird baths. Although Carla, she always tells, because even my other housemate, he does the same thing. We wash our dishes pretty much in the kitchen sink, and that's where we bathe also, And she knows this, and she likes to tear a person down. Ah, y'all fucked up. Yeah, I see you. You acted like you're homeless and everything. Well, yeah, because you don't give us the room. Even if he already had enough, because, if he was taking a shower, if I was taking a shower, she messes with the water, and it's just bad. Y'all taking whore baths. Y'all taking a whore bath. She is the most foul-mouthed. And she's for a 63-year-old woman. I've never, not even when I was homeless, did I ever encounter anyone remotely like that. I don't care what color of skin you was, what race you were, how mentally ill you were. She is definitely by far the most nastiest. She says that my other housemate and I, that we act like we're homeless. What she's actually talking about is, she's talking about the way she's acting, and she brings in her kids and everything and does whatever she does. And she says the things because she really wants us to confront her. She's so combative. First of all, she loves to hear herself talk. When she's bored in her room or whatever, she'll just make a phone call or whatever and call up someone. And the conversation starts off to be a little bit, okay. And then she goes off to where I say that she likes to hear herself talk, because then she just goes off on a tandem. Oh, well, you're fucked up and you're doing this and you do that. She's always pointing the finger somewhere else. And I think it's that she's projecting her life, her lifestyle, or her situation upon someone else. Because whatever she's doing, it seems that she's trying to project it on my housemate and I. It doesn't make sense. And all the lies and everything. And she had been cleaning the front room a little bit. She got rid of a lot of junk, a lot of stuff that her son had picked up, you know, being homeless and stuff like that. And he comes home with all sorts of shit, a lot of power tools too. Aside from the bicycles and everything, I think they got rid of the lawnmower. There was a lawnmower on the front porch several months. And it's like, first of all, the landlord has a lawn service, so they come once a week and they do the lawn for the church and the house. So it's like, why? So I don't know where that lawnmower came. And there's always been power tools. That's fucked up. Whenever I'd see a power tool, I'm like thinking, well, man, there's some poor bastard construction guy, you know, without his, probably goes to his truck or wherever he had his power tools or whatever, and he's like. And still, even now, there's like one of those little Tykes big red wagons in the front yard. There's another homeless grandma shopping cart. There's other stuff in there. And in the dumpster, there's a whole bunch of crap that she got rid of and stuff that. And I heard her talking to someone else saying, oh, yeah, you know, I told my son the bar, yeah. You know, and I even told my roommates, you know, not to let the kids in. They're always, you know, they lock up the room and everything, but when they leave, they leave the house unlocked. That's not true. Especially the back door, because last year, her kids were always coming through the back and stuff like that. And so we made sure that the door was locked. And I even pressed the fact that, you know, especially since the crime has spiked here in Pasadena. And we've had a lot of break-ins and stuff like that. And I don't want to wake up in the middle of the night, whether it's one of her people or someone breaking into the house. And we've had a lot of just daytime break-ins too. It's just phenomenal how the crime here in Pasadena has really, really spiked. A lot of this shit is also Gascon here in L.A. County. But she said, oh yeah, I talked to my roommates, you know, make sure you lock the doors, don't let my kids in, and if they come in, they need to ask me first. It's like, she's never spoken to us about that. She doesn't give a shit. She, whenever we leave, especially during the middle of the night, she always makes sure that she unlocks the front door, so her kids, as they're knocking on the door, Ma, it's me. So they come in, and they come in through the front door. She's such a POS. But anyway, I had to go to Salvation Army and the Methodist Church over here and get some supplies and everything. And I got to call back the attorney this morning because they haven't called yet. So I'm gonna give them about another half hour, or at least up until I get to the house and go back to Starbucks and prepare this video and upload it. Yeah, tough love. This is tough love. This is what I do to sustain myself. Yeah. I think you must suffer from EDD. Such a penile fracture you are. No treatment pills or surgery would help you. Limp Bizkit. Anyway, folks, I'm going to leave it here. Now that the Metro is charging again, after 2 years, and we already knew this was coming, but yesterday, you know, they started charging again. So it's $1.75 and everything, just to get on the bus. I can get on the Pasadena Arts for 35 cents, only because of the snow. That's for a senior, and I'm not even a senior status yet. So 60, 62, I think, is what the age was. But as long as it actually, Pasadena Arts Transportation Services, as long as you put in whatever you can put in, they really don't mind. They do frown really on when you're trying to hijack a free ride. They really don't like that. So I just try to carry the 35 cents because normally it's 75 cents for full fare in Pasadena. $1.75 here, $1.50 for Foothill Transit, I believe. So it's expensive. Still a lot cheaper than owning a car for my financial status that I see. But overall, I mean, here in California, you're paying an average now. It was 2 years ago, 19 something cents a gallon. We are now paying, we as a whole, are paying 51 cents per gallon in taxes. It was supposed to go up this year. It already went up last year. But I think the governor is trying to put a halt on that for right now. Whatever good graces he's trying to get into, I don't know. But anyway, my friends, I will post this as soon as I can. You folks take care of yourselves, take care of each other, but always take care of yourselves first. Love one another, trust one another, be kind to each other, help one another. Don't take today for granted or any other day thereafter. Live for the moment, pull down your pants and slide on that ice. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up. Like what I'm doing, we're doing, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notification button. Tell your friends and family about me, about us, what's going on, and just trying to get some supplies here. Whatever little I get really, really helps. And I only get what I can use. I never try to only in bags and stuff, and whatever I don't use, I always take to the Robinson Center for the other homeless folks. So, all right, my friends, I will talk to you later. I love you all. Stay safe, be smart, and be kind. Bye-bye.